With time, the Queen's popularity rose again. Thousands packed the streets to celebrate jubilees in 2002 and 2012. This during a period of rejuvenated enthusiasm for the royals, boosted by the marriages of her grandchildren and the births of her great-grandchildren, ensuring the royal tradition would carry on in future generations. Even as she lost her own husband, Prince Philip, in 2021, public sympathy poured out, and royal watchers reaffirmed their judgment of her as a stabilizing force who steered Britain through the good times and the bad.
You're watching ongoing coverage from us here at France 24 of the death of Queen Elizabeth. The world reacting as it digests the news that Queen Elizabeth has died at the age of 96. The world's longest serving monarch, spending exactly 70 years on the throne. Then King Charles III, now the new monarch. Very glad you could join us. So, a stateswoman of unmatched dignity, said the US's Joe Biden. A constant presence in our lives, said Canada's Justin Trudeau. A queen well widely admired for her grace, her dignity and dedication, said the UN's Antonio Guterres. A life of undimmed duty, that from the Premier of the tiny British territory of Bermuda. Tributes then pouring in still from right around the world in homage to Queen Elizabeth II, the world's longest serving monarch who's died at the age of 96. You can see their live images of the outside of Buckingham Palace. The crowds are obviously now subsiding. It's 4 o'clock in the morning here in Paris, 3 a.m. in London. So a quiet night there in front of Buckingham Palace before I'm sure the crowds begin to descend again in the daylight hours. 70 years on the throne she had, seeing 13 US presidents, 15 UK prime ministers, beginning all the way back with Winston Churchill. A remarkable life and a truly remarkable woman. Her loss felt right around the world. The death of Queen Elizabeth felt most profoundly in Britain itself. Almost the entire country, of course, living with the Queen on the throne, just the very eldest remembering the reign of her father. It really is the end of an era for the British monarchy and the British people. Monica Behel takes a look at the national atmosphere.
It's a historic announcement many Britons will remember forever.
Buckingham Palace has announced the death of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. In a statement, the palace said the Queen died peacefully at Balmoral this afternoon.
As the UK state broadcaster interrupted programming to announce the death of its monarch. Outside Buckingham Palace, as the flag flew at half-mast, mourners gathered all day since the announcement, laying flowers, singing the national anthem, and to pay their respects.
I thought she was fantastic and, like I said, a role model for everybody and never put a foot wrong, did she?
People have complicated thoughts about monarchies and the royal family and empires and things like that. I think that's okay, but she's, like, a really remarkable figure. You know, she's been leader of this country for so many decades.
I can't really believe it, to be honest, because she's been obviously queen my whole life, so just what's going to happen now, really.
Regardless of what your views on her are, I think that, you know, she presided over a very important time for this country.
And outside the Queen's other property, Windsor Castle, more Britons gathered, with many moved to tears by the news.
We've all known just one queen. She's the person we've always looked up to.
She led this country with great reverence and duty and respect and honour, and I just don't know if there'll be another like her.
The homage for Her Majesty is set to continue in the UK, where 10 days of national mourning, as well as the Queen's funeral procession, are due to begin on Friday.
Well, meanwhile, then, tributes are pouring in from world leaders and influential figures. Canada's Prime Minister, as I said, Justin Trudeau, gave a very emotional speech that bid farewell to, as he put it, one of his favourite people in the world. The UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres saying the Queen was a reassuring presence throughout decades of sweeping change. Keris Garland has more.
With the Union Jack flying at half-mast, the United Kingdom enters a period of mourning. At the news of Queen Elizabeth's death, crowds gathered outside Buckingham Palace, undeterred by the rain. While Prime Minister Liz Truss praised her as the very spirit of Great Britain, opposition leader Keir Starmer hailed a remarkable sovereign.
Above the clashes of politics, She stood not for what the nation fought over, but what it agreed upon, a symbol of the best of us.
Commonwealth leaders also paid tribute. Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau said the Queen had a deep, abiding love and affection for the people of his country.
Canada is in mourning. She was one of my favorite people in the world, and I will miss her so.
Indian PM Narendra Modi said he would never forget her warmth and kindness, especially when she showed him a handkerchief gifted to her by Mahatma Gandhi, while Australia's leader praised the fidelity, integrity and humour in which the Queen carried out her duties. In Paris, a portrait of the former monarch hung outside the Élysée Palace, while President Macron paid tribute to her on Twitter, remembering her as a friend of France and a kind-hearted queen who has left a lasting impression on her country and her century. Flags also flew at half-mast in Washington, D.C. President Joe Biden and First Lady Jill said she charmed us with her wit, moved us with her kindness, and generously shared with us her wisdom. Above all, the Queen is being remembered as a figure of stability across a turbulent period in history after 70 years on the throne.